Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, Mr. Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva, former President of Brazil, Srimati Sonia Gandhi, Chairperson, Indira Gandhi Memorial Trust, distinguished members of the jury, ladies and gentlemen. The presentation of Indira Gandhi Peace Prize for Peace, Disarmament and Development for the year 2010 is a key event in the calendar of global peace, development and disarmament. Today, we recognize and honor a contemporary world leader for his substantial contribution towards the achievement of these universal aspirations. This prestigious award celebrates the legacy of late Srimati Indira Gandhi as an untiring crusader for global peace, universal disarmament, and a new international economic order. She won the mandate of the Indian people at a time in our recent history when our country was faced with serious domestic and external challenges. In her characteristic style, she approached these with due urgency, armed with the principles that Mahatma Gandhi taught and lived by, and the policies of her visionary father, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. For me personally, this day is a reminder of my own association with one of the most dynamic prime ministers of modern India, a tall leader acclaimed internationally, whose dedications and commitment to the people that she represented was total and unparalleled. Srimati Indira Gandhi was very clear that India had to be self-reliant, and her first concern always was national interest. In the socio-economic developments of India, Srimati Indira Gandhi reached out to the poorest and the most deprived. Her call for the growth with social justice became a motto for her government. It drove home the point that growth to India had to go hand in hand with equitable distribution of its benefits. It made prudent management of resources and revenues a priority, so also to creation of the institutions and programs for social changes, such as empowerment of Panchayati Raj institution, strengthening of public distribution system, initiating of midday meal schemes for school children, empowerment of scheduled castes and tribes, among others. It was Srimati Indira Gandhi who steered India's state and business sectors into a cooperative alliance for economic growth. Improving production was her top priority. She put out a new industrial policy to encourage expansion and also provided finance and tax relief to encourage investment. Special legislations were passed to discourage strikes and labor unrest. The nationalization of banks not only helped to increase the household savings, but it also provided considerable investments in the informal sector in small and medium enterprises and agriculture. Thanks to her bold initiatives, the Indian economy today is more resilient and confident. Two decades of steady economic reforms have contributed to an improvement to average income and consumption levels in both rural and urban areas. There is a newfound dynamism in some of the most backward areas, bringing them into the national economic mainstream. Environment and energy were high priority issues on Mrs. Gandhi's agenda. I recall that once she had written to chief ministers of all these states suggesting to drive a plant of tree for every child. She stressed the value of the traditional energy-saving technologies and welcomed the development of new technologies and their adaptation to India's needs. At the global level, Srimati Indira Gandhi, while meticulously in her attention to detail, had a very clear perspective. She was a firm believer that only with coexistence could there be any existence at all. I would like to recall her words that are so relevant today. She said, and I quote a few words, "We regard non-interference and non-intervention as basic laws of international behavior. Yet, different types of intervention, open or covert, do take place in Asia, in Africa, in Latin America. They are all intolerable and unacceptable. Interference leads to intervention, and one intervention often attracts another. Each situation of conflict has its own origins. Whatever they be, solutions must be political and peaceful. All states must abide by the principle that force on the or the threat of force will not be used against the territorial integrity or political independence of another state. Our plans for a better life for each of our people depend on world peace and the reverse of the arms race," unquote. Her theme remained constant: the interrelation of security, development, and the environment. She believed that nationalism should not detach people from common humanity. She was convinced of the need to create, I quote, "a new international order of humanity where power is tempered with compassion, where knowledge and capability are at services of all humanity," unquote. As chairperson of the Non-Aligned Movement, she had remarked while addressing the United Nations in 1983 that safety of the weak is the strength of the strong. Srimati Indira Gandhi firmly believed that smaller nations had a key role in determining the future of the world. She referred to developing countries as the stepchildren of the Industrial Revolution and said that they needed to be given due justice. In pursuing India's aims, she never acted against the aspirations of other developing nations or compromised their priorities. She held that the myriad problems related to the environment, optimal utilization of the global resources, and the reorganization of the political and economic systems needed the cooperation and cooperative endeavors of the whole world community. Srimati Indira Gandhi shall be remembered for her untiring efforts of maintaining cohesion, unity, and enhanced economic cooperation among developing nations, their autonomous development, collective self-reliance, equitable and democratic dialogue between the North and the South.